Pardon me for asking, but who's that little old man?
What little old man?
That little old man.
Oh, that one, that's my grandfather.
Your grandfather?
Yeah.
That's not your grandfather.
It is, you know.
But I've seen your grandfather. He lives in your house.
Oh, that's my other grandfather, but he's my grandfather as well.
How do you reckon that one out?
Well, everyone's entitled to two, aren't they? And it's my other one.
We know that, but what's he doing here?
Well, my mother thought the trip would do him good.
How's that?
He's nursing a broken heart.
Ah, poor old thing. Hey, mister. Are you nursing a broken heart? He's a nice old man, isn't he?
He's very clean.
Hello, grandfather.
Hello.
He can talk then, can he?
Of course he can talk, he's a human being, isn't he?
Well, if he's your grandfather, who knows?
And we're looking after him, are we?
I look after myself.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of.
He's got you worried then.
Him?
He's a villain. A real mixer. And it costs you a fortune in breach of promise cases.
Get on.
No, straight up.
I am.
Hello, Sheikh.
Hello, Sheikh.
You got on all right, then?
No.
Oh. Well, we're here. Norm will be along in a minute with the tickets.
Hey,
who's the little old man?
It's Paul's grandfather.
Oh, aye, but I thought...
Nah, that's his other one.
Oh, that's all right then.
Clean though, isn't he?
Oh, he's very clean.
Morning, lads.
Morning,
Norm. Oh, thank God you've all got here. Now look, I've had a marvellous idea. Just for once, let's all try to behave like ordinary, respectable citizens. Let's not cause any trouble, pull any strokes, or do anything I'm gonna be sorry for. Especially tomorrow in that television theatre. Because... Are you listening to me, Lennon?
You're a swine. Isn't he, George? You're a swine.
Thanks.
Hey!
Who's that little old man?
Well, who is he?
He belongs to Paul.
Oh, well. I'm going down for a cup of coffee. Anyone coming?
We'll follow you down.
I want me coffee.
Well, you can come with Sheikh and me if you like.
Look after him, I don't want to find you've lost him.
Don't be cheeky. I'll bind him to me with promises. very clean, isn't he? Come on, Grandad.
Make up your mind, will you?
Do you mind if we have it out? Yes, I do. Yeah, but the four of us, we'd like it open. Not if it's all the same to you, that is. It isn't. I travel on this train regularly, twice a week. So I suppose I've some rights. So have we. Knowledge of the Railway Act would tell you that I'm perfectly within my rights.
Yeah, but we want to hear it.
There's more of us than you. We're a community and charity vote up the workers and all that stuff. Then I suggest you take that damn thing into the corridor. Or some other part of the train. Why you want to slip along. Give us a kiss. Look, mister, we pay for our seats too, you know. I travel on this train regularly, twice a week. Knock it off, Paul. You can't win with his sword. After all, it's his train, isn't it, mister? And don't take that turn with me, young man. I fought the war for your sword.
I bet you saw you won.
I shall call the guard.
Ah, but what? They don't take kindly to insults, you know. Come on, let's go and have some coffee and leave the kennel to Lassie.
You want to watch it?
Well, it's not my fault.
You stick to that story, son.
I can't help it. I'm just taller than you are.
They always say that.
Well, I've got my eye on you.
I'm sorry, Norm. I can't help being taller than you.
Well, talk up it then. I've a good mind to thump you, Shake.
Hey, if you're gonna have a Barney, can I hold your coat?
He started it.
I did not, you did.
Well, what happened?
The old fella said that could he have these pictures, and Norm said no, and all I said was, well, why not be big about it?
And?
Your grandfather pointed out that Shake was always being taller than me just to spite me.
I knew it. He started it. I should have known.
Sure.
You two have never had an argument in your life. And in 2 minutes flat, he's got you at it. He's a king mixer. He hates group unity, so he gets everyone at it. Well, I suggest you just give him the photos and have done with it.
Oh, all right, show devil. Yeah.
Hey, Paulie, would you ever sign one of them for us?
Ah, come ahead, Shake.
Hey, look at the talent. Let's give him a pull, should I? Aye, but don't rush none of your five-bar gate jumps and over sorts of stuff.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't know. I thought it just sounded distinguished like.
George Harrison's cars are distinguished.
Excuse me, madam. Excuse me, but these young men I'm sitting with wondered if two of us could come over and join you.
I'd ask you myself, only I'm shy.
I'm sorry, miss. You mustn't patronize us meat prisoners.
Prisoners?
Convict in transit, tipping low legs than off them.
You are.
You are.
Get out, ladies! Get out while you can!
He's been gone a long time.
Who?
Paul's grandfather.
Oh, I didn't notice. Where'd he go?
Down the,
Oh, we'll give him a couple of minutes then.
Hey, have you seen Paul's grandfather?
Of course he's concealed about me person.
Now, he must have slipped off somewhere.
Have you lost him?
Now, don't exaggerate.
You've lost him!
Look, put it this way, Paulie. He's mislaid him.
Honest, you can't trust you with anything, Norm. If you've lost him, I'll cripple you.
He can't have got far.
Come, Ed, let's look up the sharp end.
What's the matter with you, then?
It's his grandfather. I can tell he doesn't like me. It's because I'm little.
Now, you've got an inferiority complex, you have.
Yeah, no, that's why I play the drums. It's my active compensatory factor.
going in then?
No, she'll only reject me in the end. I'll be frustrated.
You never know, you may be lucky this time.
No, I know the psychological pattern. It plays havoc with me drum skins.
Excuse me, have you seen that little old man we were with?
Broken out of the blessed freedom of it all. Have you got a nerve, pal? These handcuffs are killing me. I won't name the ministers, I don't want to go.
Sorry for disturbing you, girls.
I bet you can't guess what I was in for.
Should we go in here?
Nah, it's probably a honeymoon couple or a company director or something.
Well, I don't care. I'm gonna broaden my outlook.
Congratulate me, boys. I'm engaged.
Oh, no, you're not this time.
And to think me own grandson would have let them put me behind bars.
Don't dramatize. Let's face it, you're lucky to be here. They'd have had their own way. You would have been dropped off already. But you've got to admit, you've upset a lot of people.
At least I can keep my eye on you while you're stuck in here.
Odds or evens?
Odds.
Don't worry, son, we'll get you the best lawyer green stamps can buy.
Oh, it's a laugh a line with Leonard. Anyway, it's your fault.
Why me?
Why not you?
God, it's depressing in here, isn't it? Funny. I usually reckon dogs more than people in England. You'd expect something more palatial. Let's do something then.
Like what?
Okay. God, it's the girls. I'll see them.
Aye, aye, the Liverpool Shuffle.
You, two, me, three, them.
I would love every
out in his lucky rings.
All mine!
They aren't by your happiness, my son.
Hey! Don't move, any of you. They've gone potty out there. The place is surging with girls.
Please, sir, can I have one to surgery, sir, please, sir?
No, you can't. Now, listen, as soon as I tell you, get out through this door here into that big car that's waiting.
On a nose.
Aw, oh, you pick on your own.
Hey, here.
Those yours?
No, they're for Ringo.
Must have cost you a fortune in stamps, Ringo.
He comes from a large family.
Well? What's the Circle Club?
The management of the Circle Club takes pleasure in requesting the company of Mr. Richard Starkey, that's you, to their gaming rooms, Chemin de Fer, Baccarat and Champagne Buffet.
They want me. It's got around here a big spender.
Well, you're not going.
Quite right. Invites to gambler dens full of easy money and fast women. Chicken sandwiches and cornets and caviar. Disgusting.
That's mine.
Come out, you lot. Get your pens out.
Why?
It's homework time for you load of college puddings. I want this lot answered tonight.
I want to go out.
Now I'll brook no denial.
You couldn't get a pen in your foot, you swine.
Ooh, chatter on, son, chatter on. A touch of the writer's cramp will soon sort you out. Come out, shake. Well, then.
See ya. Where are you going, then? Well, he told us to stay, didn't he? Come out! Couldn't we get a taxi?
No, we can't get a taxi.
Man.
I'll clear up, so. Yeah.
I wanna be your man.
Hello, monsieur. souffle.
I bet you're a great swimmer.
My turn. Bingo.
Ah, bingo, Monsieur Bongo.
I'll take the little darlings anyway. Two and one and three, carry one and four.
Huit. Eset.
I can't believe that she would leave me on my own. It's just alright when every night I'm all alone. I've got no close your eyes and I'll kiss you tomorrow. I'll miss you. Remember, I'll always be true. And then why?
He's right, you know. There you go.
Hey, what's all this?
Oh, Emmy's been lurking. He looks a right lurker, doesn't he?
You're undressed. What are your clothes?
The old gentleman. He borrowed them to go gambling at the sack.
He's gone to my club, has he?
Yeah, it's all your fault.
What?
Getting invites to gambling clubs and all that. He's probably in the middle of some orgy by now.
Orgy?
Too old.
Oh, good, something, monsieur. Oh, yeah. And I'll have some more champagne as well.
Lord John McCartney, millionaire Irish peer. Filthy rich, of course.
I don't know. He looks quite clean to me.
Come here, you lot. Try to act with a bit of decorum. This is a posh place.
We know how to behave. We've had lessons.
Well, I'm sorry, sir. Members and invited guests only. Oh, yes.
I'm with them. I'm Ringo's sister.
Excuse me, have you got a little old man here?
Do you mean old McCartney?
Oh, he's at it again. Look, I'm his grandfather.
There's the little matter of the bill.
I'll take care of that.
£180?
I beg your pardon. Guineas.
Your winnings, my lord, £190.
What about me change?
Pilgrim charge.
Oh, well, easy come, easy go. Well?
Good morning, my head. Cozy knock-eyed tea harbor. Ah, it's a fancy Englander. Pretty boggy.
Keep Britain tiny. Oh, go on, George.
Don't be ridiculous.
But you said I could.
Honestly, my mind boggles at the very idea. A grown man and you haven't shaved with a safety razor.
It's not my fault. I come from a long line of electricians.
Well, you're not practicing on me.
All right, then. But show us.
Oh, come on, man.
Oh, man.
Thank you.
lasting much longer.
Why do you think we're laying off here, man?
Boys, come on,
oh,
your press conference.
Where have you been? Your press conference we're arranging. Yes.
Oh, all right. Give us a couple of shakes to get out of breath.
Give us a shout when it's over.
Yeah,
well, they have a suit just like him, you know.
Ring
him. Hostages.
Yeah.
I don't like the handkerchief. I always have the handkerchief in my trouser pocket.
Oh.
You can't blow your nose on it up there, can you, mister?
No, you can't.
Yeah.
anything left?
We just finished, Polly.
Hey, George, give us your John Henry on that picture.
Hey, look at that.
What's that?
It's not all set down there.
Oh, should we go down? Have a go.
Yeah, come on,
trees and everything.
Not a fellas for one sec.
Sorry, tree.
It is.
Look, it's a bird. Just passing through life.
Where are they?
Leave them drums alone.
Oh, surely I could just have a little touch.
You so much as breathe heavy on them and I'm out on strike.
Aren't you being rather arbitrary?
There you go, hiding behind a smokescreen of bourgeois cliches. I don't go messing about with your earphones, do I?
Spoil sport.
Well?
He's very fussy about his drums, you know. They loom large in his legend.
What's up?
Oh, he's sulking again.
I'll show him.
Oh, please.
excuse partner, I'd like more drums there.
No, I think it's on that.
It sounds like it.
On the other cover, right?
On cover.
The third bit, you know,
no, the third bit. Okay. More bang!
What? Let you know more about it, you're probably right. Now look, if you think I'm unsuitable, let's have it out in the open. I can't stand these backstage politics.
Aren't you turning to black and white the situation somewhat?
Well, quite honestly, I wasn't expecting a musical arranger to question my ability picture-wise.
I could listen to him for hours.
What's all this about a musical arranger?
Mr. McCartney, Sr.
Hey, Paulie, they're trying to fob you off with this musical charlatan. But I gave him the test.
I'm quite happy to be replaced.
He's a typical book passer.
I won an award.
A likely story.
It's on the wall in my office. Hello, Arnold. Everybody happy?
All right, if you don't need them, I'll lock them up in the dressing room.
Please do, I'll not need them for half an hour.
Thank you.
Have you a bottle of milk and some tranquilizers? I see it all now, it's a plot. A plot?
Come out, you lot have got the key.
I saw your father in the old empire in 1909. If you're as good as him, son, you're all right.
I suppose you realize this is private property.
Sorry we hurt your field, mister.
Not here. Hello, Dickie.
Probably out of the canteen. Cup of tea, like.
No, that's too easy for him. He's out there somewhere. Caught in trouble. Just upset me.
You're imagining it, Norm. You're letting it prey on your mind.
No, this is a battle of nerves between John and me.
John hasn't got any.
What?
Nerves?
No. That's just the trouble. I've toyed with the idea of a ball and chain. He'd just rattle them at me and in public too. Sometimes I think he enjoys seeing me suffer.
Hello.
Hello. Oh, wait a minute.
No, I'm not.
Oh, you are.
I'm not.
Oh, you are. I know you are.
I'm not, no.
You look just like him.
Do I? You're the first one that said that ever.
Yes, you do look.
Now my eyes are lighter. All right, Noddy.
Oh,
your nose.
Yes, yeah. Your nose is very.
Is it?
I would
have
said so.
Oh, you know I'm better.
I do not. It's only a casual acquaintance.
That's what you say.
What have you heard?
It's all over the place.
Is it really?
I wouldn't have it. I stuck up for it.
I knew I could rely on you. Thanks. You don't look like him at all.
She looks more like him than I do.
There will be a full rehearsal in 10 minutes' time. 10 minutes from now, a full rehearsal.
Oh, sorry, must have made a mistake.
No, you haven't. You're just late. Actually, I think he'll be very pleased with you.
Will he?
Yes, you're quite a feather in the cap. Hello? I've got one. Oh, I think so. Yes, he can talk. No, well, I think you ought to see him. Yes, all right.
see many of these nowadays, do you?
He'll look good alongside Susan.
All right, Sonny Jim, this is all going to be quite painless. Don't breathe on me, Adrian. I'm terribly sorry, but there seems to be some sort of misunderstanding.
Oh, you can come off it with us. You don't have to do all the old adenoidal glottal stop and carry on for our benefit.
I'm afraid I don't understand.
Oh my God, he's a natural.
Well, I did tell them not to send his real ones.
They ought to know by now the phonies are much easier to handle. Still, he's a good type. We'd like you to give us your opinion on some clothes for teenagers.
Oh, by all means, I'd be quite prepared for that eventuality.
Well, not your real opinion, naturally. It'll be written out and you'll learn it. Can you read?
Of course I can.
I mean lines, Ducky. Can you handle lines?
Well, I'll have a bash.
Good. Give him whatever it is they drink. A Coca-Rama? Well, at least he's polite. Show him the shirts, Adrian. Now, you'll like these. You'll really dig them. They're fab and all the other pimply hyperboles.
I wouldn't be seen dead in them. The dead grotty.
Grotty?
Yeah, grotesque.
Make a note of that word and give it to Susan. It's rather touching, really. Here's this kid trying to give me his utterly valueless opinion when I know for a fact that within a month he'll be suffering from a violent inferiority complex and loss of status because he isn't wearing one of these nasty things.
Of course they're grotty, you wretched nit. That's why they were designed. But that's what you'll want.
I won't.
You can be replaced, chicky baby.
I don't care.
That pose is out too, Sammy Jim. The new thing is to care passionately and be right-wing. Anyway, if you don't cooperate, you won't meet Susan.
And who's this Susan when she's at home?
Only Susan can be, our resident teenager. Yeah. You'll have to love her. She's your symbol.
Oh, you mean that posh bird who gets everything wrong?
I beg your pardon.
Oh, yeah, the lads frequently sit round the television and watch her for a giggle. In fact, once we all sat down, wrote these letters saying how gear she was and all that rubbish.
She's a trendsetter. It's her profession.
She's a drag, a well-known drag. Turn the sound down on her and say rude things.
Get him out of here.
Have I said something amiss?
Get him out of here. He's blocking the program's image.
Sorry about the shirt.
Get him out!
You don't think he's a new phenomenon, do you?
You mean an early clue to the new direction?
Where's the calendar? Just a troublemaker. The change isn't due for 3 weeks yet. All the same, make a note not to extend Susan's contract. Let's not take any unnecessary chances.
Gib der Fein Rüstung schon zu vergessen.
As I explained to my mother, he was a very clean man. She was frightened.
That's wrong, isn't it? Surely that's wrong. No, not you.
Get him out!
Someone coming. Wait, why?
Being taller than me.
Stop, boy.
Faithful God.
What are you doing here?
Hiding.
You must be soft or something.
But we weren't hiding, we were resting.
I thought I told you not to stop here.
Well?
When I say stay put, I mean stay put.
Don't cane me, sir. I was led astray.
Oh, shut up, John.
They're waiting for you in the studio.
Gee, I'm down to do a bit of work.
Oh, God bless you, Ringo.
Oh, this is the teacher's pet.
Crawler.
Take the class, eh?
I'll lay off.
Tempered well!
You get a move, I'm not waiting for you.
Sorry.
I now declare this bridge open.
Where are they? Where are they? Where are they? They're coming. They're coming, I promise you. Ah, yes, well, if they aren't on this floor in 30 seconds, there'll be trouble. Understand me? Trouble. Standing about, eh? Some people have it dead easy. Once you're over 30, you're past it. It's a young man's medium. I just can't stand the pace.
Oh, he's young as that then.
I was.
Ah, there he goes. Look at him. I bet his wife doesn't know about her.
I bet he hasn't even
got a wife. Look at his sweater.
Never know, she might have knitted him.
She knitted him.
And stand by, run to your number and try not to jiggle out of position. Hello, three, coming to you. Three, coming to you. Three.
We're on three. Three.
What?
We're on three.
Oh, yes. Music.
As long as
We'll just powder them off for the shine.
Oh, yes, sir. Norm, would you take them on the makeup and powder them off the shine?
Sure.
You blinked?
Come on.
Oh, lads! Hey, grandfather's not talking to me. I think he's got a soul comp.
Must be catchy on. He's giving it to Ringo here.
Stop picking on
me.
I don't need you to protect me, no.
I got a touch of the swine fever, haven't it?
No, come on, lads. Sit down.
Possible. We'll never get them all done in time.
Then you have to do us first. It doesn't matter to them whether they're made up or not. By the way, what's that?
My name's Betty.
Do you want a punch of your frog tunic?
No.
John, behave yourself or I'll murder you. Shay, take that wig off. It suits you. Bingo, what are you up to?
Page 5. You always fancied yourself as a guardsman, didn't you?
Oh, that this total solid flesh would melt.
Hey, you won't interfere with the basic rugged concept of my personality, will you, madam? Hey, he's reading the Queen. That's an in-joke, you know.
Shut up!
It's my considered opinion that you're a bunch of sissies.
Just yours.
Leave him alone, Lennon, or I'll tell him all the truth about you.
You wouldn't.
Oh, I would, though.
Lovers, I thought I was supposed to be getting a change of scenery, and so far I've been in a train and a room, and a car and a room, and a room and a room. Well, maybe that's all right for a bunch of powdered geegaws like you lot, but I'm feeling decidedly straight-jacketed.
What a clean old man.
Don't pressure, look.
He's sex-obsessed. The older generation leading this country to galloping ruin.
What's a pretty girl like you doing in a place like this?
They're nearly ready for you, lads. Just finishing the band call.
I say, did you go to Harrods? How's them 58, you know? I can get you on the stage.
Oh, Harold!
Return right here at the corridor and go past the fireplace. And don't like yours.
Thank you.
Look at him, sitting there with his hooter scraping away at that boog.
Well, what's the matter with that?
Have you no natural resources of your own?
Have they even robbed you of that?
You can learn from books.
You can you? Sheep's heads. You can learn more by getting out there and living.
Out where?
Any old where. But not her, little Richard. Oh, no. When you're not pumping them pagan skins, you're tormenting your eyes with that rubbish.
Books are good.
Parading's better.
Parading?
Parading the streets. Trailing your coat. Bowling along. Living.
Well, I am living.
You? Living? When was the last time you gave a girl a pink-edged daisy? When did you last embarrass a Sheila with your cool appraising stare?
Been all for that sort of chat, aren't you?
Well, at least I've got a backlog of memories. All you've got is that book.
Oh, stop picking on me as bad as the rest of them.
Ah, so you are a man after all.
What's that mean?
Do you think I haven't noticed? Do you think I wasn't aware of the drift? And you poor unfortunate scruff. They've driven you into books with our cruel unnatural treatment, exploiting your good nature.
I don't know.
I should that lot never happy unless they're jeering ya. And where'd they be without the steady support of your drumbeat? That's what I'd like to know.
That's right.
And what's it all come to in the end?
Yeah, what's in it for me?
A book.
Yeah, a blooming book.
When you could be out there betraying a rich American widow, or sipping palm wine in Tahiti before you're too old like me.
Yeah, funny really, because I never thought, but being middle-aged and old takes up most of your time, doesn't it?
You're only right. Where are you going?
I'm going parading before it's too late.
Hey, Ringo, you know what just happened to me?
No, I don't. You want to stop looking so scornful, it's twisting your face. Tell him of the story, brother.
Hello, here he is, the middle-aged boy wonder.
Yeah, I saw you were looking after the old man.
Hey,
We have about half an hour to the final run-through. He can't walk on us now.
Can't he? He's done it, son.
Hey, you know all that?
We know.
Your grandfather, he stirred him up.
He hasn't.
Yeah, he filled his head with notions, seemingly.
The old mixer, come on, we'll have to put him right.
Can we have all guards on stage for rehearsal?
Split up and look for him.
We've become a limited company.
I looked in here again.
Thank you.
I'm chugging bricks about.
Southerner?
The hoop, the lethal weapon. Have you got a license for it?
Oh, don't be so stroppy.
Well, a boy your age rolling hoops of people. How old are you anyway?
11.
I bet you're only 10 now.
10 2/3.
There you are, then. And don't be rolling with people.
Oh, you can have it. I'm packing in, it depresses me.
You are?
You heard? Get something quick.
That's lovely talk, that is. Why aren't you at school?
I'm deserted.
Are you now?
Yeah, I've blown school out.
Just you?
No. Ginger, Eddie Fallon, and Ding Dong.
Oh, Ding Dong Ballet?
Right. I was supposed to come with us, but they chickened.
Yeah? They're your mates, are they?
Yeah.
What's cop without them, isn't it?
Oh, it's alright.
Yeah, what are they like?
Ginger's mad. He says things all the time. And Eddie's good at spitting and punching.
Yeah, how about Ding Dong?
Oh, he's a bigot. He fancies himself. You know, it's all right, though, because he's won the game. Why aren't you at work?
I'm a deserter, too.
Hey, Charlie!
I'm sorry, boys. I didn't mean it. Honest.
If he says that again, I'll strike him.
Oh, don't worry. The good lads, they'll be back.
Yes, we'll be only 20 minutes to the final run-through.
I meant no harm. I was only trying to encourage little Ringo to enjoy himself.
God knows what you've unleashed on the unsuspecting South. It'll be wine, women, and song all the way with Ringo when he gets the taste for it.
That was fresh this morning, 2 and 9.
Thank you.
right. On your way.
You what?
You heard. On your way, troublemaker.
Kid. Shake.
What?
Bully, will ya? Well, that's it. 2 minutes to the final run. They're bound to miss it now.
Murder that lemon.
Still, we could survive a missed run through as long as
they... As long as they head up for the show. Oh, you're right there. I mean, it wouldn't do to miss the show, like, would it?
Shut up, cheerful. You don't think? Oh, no. Now, look, don't worry. They can't do this to me, no. It's all your fault. Oh, yes, it is. If they don't turn up, I wouldn't be in your shoes for
all the tea in China. No, you're right there, neither would I.
You dirty traitor.
Well, of course.
Yes, of course. John!
Did you want something?
Oh, I could eat the lot of you. You look graver than apple in me, dog. Do you realize you could have missed the final run through?
I was sorry about that.
No, there's only three of them.
Oh, we were looking for Ringo, but we realized he must have come back here. Well, do you realize that we're on the air live in front of an audience in 45 minutes and you're one short?
Control yourself, you spurt. He must be here somewhere.
Ah, but we'll look in the dressing room. Shake?
Yes. To the dressing room. Yeah. It was my grandfather.
Don't worry about him, Paul. He can look after himself.
I suppose so. Personally signed and handwritten by your own sweet boys. The chance of a lifetime.
Going on there, right? Move over, move over.
Come on, move over.
Yeah.
Look, why don't you go?
Now, will you just move along?
They'll take you apart if you stand here. Now, come along. There's a good
man.
Thank you.
nasty little person you
are. You are? Oh. Yeah.
Ringo, Star, I've got a show to do. I'm on in a few minutes. You've got to let me go. Ringo.
Yeah, that's what they all say these days. Look, I don't care who you are. You can say that for the stipendiary. Here you are, Sarge.
All right. What is he?
Yeah, got a little list here. Wandering abroad. Malicious intent. Acting in a suspicious manner. Conduct liable to cause a breach of the peace. You name it, he's done it.
Oh, a little savage, is he?
Yeah, probably a little aboriginal.
I demand to see my solicitor.
What's his name?
Well, if you're gonna get technical about it...
Dragging me through the street!
Well, it's gonna be one of those nights, is it? Sit Charlie Peace down over there, will you?
Well, you got me here, so do your worst. For me, God, I take one of you with me. I know your game. It means the training room, and then out come the rubber hoses.
Oh, there's a fire, is there?
You ugly great brute. You have sadism stamped all over your bloated British kisser.
Hey?
I'll go on hunger strike. I know you're a caper. The kidney punch and the rabbit clout. The third degree and the size 12 boot ankle tap.
What's he on about?
I'm a soldier of the Republic. You'll need the mahogany truncheon on this bio. A nation once again. A nation once again.
Oh, get Lloyd George over there next to the mechanic and the cloth couple. Sort this lot out, will you? Come on, Dad. Sit down over here.
Ringo, me old scout. So they grabbed your leg for the iron too, have they?
I'm not exactly a voluntary patient.
Have they roughed you up yet?
What?
Oh, they're a desperate crew of drippings, and their fists like matured hams for pounding poor defenseless lads like you.
Right. That's it, eh?
One of us has got to escape. I'll get the boys. Hold on, son. I'll be back here.
For me?
And if they get you on the floor, watch out for your brisket.
They seem alright to me.
Sure, that's what they want you to think. All coppers are villains.
Would you two like a cup of tea?
See? Sly villains.
No thank you, Mr. Sergeant, sir. No, not for me. Please, don't.
So you just brought the old chap out of the crowd for his own good, eh?
Well, he was getting a bit nasty, you see, so we had to bring him.
Well, you can't stop here. This is the stuff you've been hawking around, isn't it?
That's hard. Photographs.
Photographs.
Well, son, it's now or never. All right, you paid assassins. Johnny McCartney'll give you a run of your certainty.
Hey, you forgot your photographs.
half an hour, and you're on.
Can I say something?
Yes.
It seems highly unlikely we'll be on. I mean, the law of averages are against it. I think if you could get the juggler on with a couple more clubs, that'd fill in a bit of time.
Go home.
I must see Polly.
Go home then and see him on the telly.
Can you fix him for me?
Yeah. 6 months. Each. In a box.
Mercenaries.
Money and money, love, and family, love. This means to me, if you hadn't come back, it would have meant the epilogue or the news in Welsh for life.
Hey, aren't you supposed to be in that box?
Yeah, it was the old mixer.
Here, Paulie.
Got a few words to say to you, two-faced John McCartney.
I'll leave Maloney's back, isn't he? It's not his fault he's old.
It's all got to do with it. He's a troublemaker and a mixer. That's good enough for me.
You're right, but he's only asking for attention, aren't you? You see, you know your trouble. You should have gone west to America. You would have been a senior citizen of Boston. You took a wrong turn and what happened? You're a lonely old man from Liverpool.
But I'm clean.
Are you?
Hey, no.
What?
I've been thinking. It's not my fault.
What is it?
I'm not taller than you are. You're smaller than I am.
Anyone at all? Hey, Shake, where's me boot? Will you get us some tea while you're there?
Hello, John.
Now, get, come on, lads, get changed.
Come on, get some tea, but all in a minute.
So what a cheese boxy, Paul.
Yeah.
Love to love you. got the stuff coming, lads.
Are we doing your...
No, we're not. The officer's been on the phone. They think it's best if we push on to Wolverhampton straight away.
Tonight, we're at a midnight...
You've got a midnight match,
eh? I know.
Now, there's only one thing I'm going to say to you, John Lennon.
What?
You're a swine.
It's been a...